glass shipping container here. Whenever you walk inside, the first thing that you notice is just how nicely kept up and organized that it is. They have all of their gardening tools for sale on the shop, including some colorful and durable twines. I like to use these often. They run a tight operation here. The co-owners, Jared and Brittany, always are so accommodating. I couldn't ask for better bosses. And as soon as you walk out here, you can see the shipping room. And that's where the whole shipping team works. And then this container turns into my work bench. So this is the area that I basically work at all day. I pull the plants, I prep the plants, I prune them, water them, and then I send them off to be shipped in the shipping room. Did I mention I also got Seth a job here as well? So we're working beside these beautiful bananas and avocado trees all day. And like I said, they have so much accommodations. And in this Florida heat, I could not ask for better. Like, they have this hydro fog, and it just makes beautiful rainbows. I seriously love my job so much. Just taking in all the peacefulness of it. It's something that I couldn't ask for more. Seriously, like, I feel so content and so happy here. And I want to show you guys everything that I get to experience. So stick around. By my workstation, I have several lady finger banana trees, and they all have racks of bananas. The flowers are so beautiful and so big. I believe they have at least 30 banana trees on their whole property. So it's so fun just seeing how we can grow edible food all around our home. Right here is a lovely avocado tree. From it. This is the Joey avocado. They turn black and you can eat the skin. They have a decent shelf life as well. I like to make guac with them sometimes. And the cool thing about my job is Jared and Brittany don't mind if you take some bananas or take some avocados. They just have so much abundance growing. Sharing it with others just brings more abundance. So, leading out from my station is the large area. It's just a walkway where we keep all of our large plants. And to the left of that, they have a massive greenhouse. It's covered with aluminum, and that helps protect the plants and divert the sunlight. So, it's very large. It contains over thousands of different plants, and these are all on their shop. And all I do all day long is walk through the greenhouse, tend to all the plants. I stake them up, I water them, I make labels for them. Just really make sure that they stay alive and well, and that way they can be shipped off and grown by everybody else. And we're always getting something new, so that's so exciting for me. I'm always learning about a new plant every single day, and everything that's in their greenhouse is medicinal. This very large fan to accommodate. So, all of the sections are labeled all by me. This is our one tray section, stuff that we only have a little bit of. And then the rest of it is kind of organized, just a little bit differently. Some of these plants are ones that they've sourced from other sellers, and then some of them are plants that come from their own food forest that either myself or Seth has propagated for them. It's always so fun to know that just like a branch can turn into a tree, and not a lot of people know that, but we make so many plants at Sow Exotic, and we bring so much abundance. Here we have the red leaf cranberry hibiscus. This is seriously one of my favorite plants. It creates a beautiful red leaf, and it's very lemon zesty, great in salad, extremely medicinal. The flowers on this, so good in tea. Here we have beside of it some aloe vera, one of the most medicinal plants in the entire world. We have some Aztec sweet herb. This is fun. It's always being pollinated. I like to just take a moment of my day and watch the bees or the wasps. This is also a favorite of mine, the Corsian mint. It is the most minty smell I've ever smelled. I'm thinking I want to use this as a ground cover someday. Like maybe in my raised garden beds or something. They have an overabundance of star fruits right now. They're just boinging and springing out of the soil. They grow so funny. They're just funky little plants. Very buoyant. Here's another one, the Everglades tomato. They're just now getting tomatoes on there, and these are a really nice seller. People love tomatoes. I've tasted these, they're little red cherry tomatoes, and they're very, very delicious. Definitely a top seller at Sow Exotic. Beside it, the achote. They make these really cool flower and seed pods, and heart-shaped leaves, so that's kind of why I like them. Beside of it, we have some anise hyssop. This is another favorite fragrant plant, and makes such beautiful purple flowers. I always see a butterfly or a bee on these. They love coming in the greenhouse and pollinating for us. They have some orange turmeric for sale, as well as some white and all different kinds of turmerics and gingers. Some rare blue turmeric, I think, or ginger. There's just so much, it's hard to remember sometimes. But these are just the regular turmerics, and as you can see, they have beautiful roots and bulbs. Another favorite is the Monstera deliciosa plant. This makes a beautiful flower and fruit. Here we have the neighbor's dog, Harley. She always comes and just says hi every single morning. Over in the large section, we have the dwarf Barbados cherry trees. These make perfect bonsais because they're already a dwarf tree. And as you can see, they're flowering right now. So they're all going to be loaded with small little Barbados cherries. Fun fact, one Barbados cherry contains 3 times the amount. citrus on the bottom rows. This is a beautiful variegated lemon. And then all throughout are just all different exotic, and some are very rare fruit trees. Almost all of them are fruiting or about to fruit this year. So we like to get these out the door as quickly as we can. And I'm constantly just taking care of these, pruning them back, making sure that they're specific height to be shipped. And many plants they're growing in here, they also have planted out in their food forest. So let's take a look. All of these random fruit trees just engulf their whole property. This one is a Florida Eugenia. I like to snack on it just every now and then. The berries are nice and sweet. Just a nice little snack to get me through my work day. Such a joy to have these plants. This one here makes such a beautiful flower. This is the African eggplant, a food known to increase brain function and also cure cancer. There's a lot of plants that not a lot of people know that are actually cancer fighting, proven to be more effective than chemotherapy. And that's also what got me into growing plants. So here is a citrus. This one, I'm not sure about what it is yet. It's just kind of chilling by the African eggplant. I can pretty much name half of the plants they have, and then the other half, I'm still learning every single day. This one here reminds me of a painting. It's the Chote. And whenever I look at it, it reminds me of like lungs or life. I don't know. They have, like I said, an overabundance of bananas. And these are plantain, another type of banana. It's a smaller but very medicinal type of banana. And these ones are fairly large. They've been growing here for quite some time. It's right beside of another beautiful fruit tree. This one here is one of my favorites I have growing at my house. This is the yellow Muntingia, or Muntingia, however you like to pronounce it. I like to call it the popcorn fruit, just because it really is like a candy tree. I like to slurp the inside, all the seeds. It's got like a million seeds. And then just toss the skin. They also have another variety of Muntingia. This one here is the red Muntingia. And same thing, similar flavor. It's got a million seeds. This one's just the red variety. So this one here is the dwarf red lady papaya tree. It's got some flowers, a few small fruits trying to come. And then beside of this papaya, has the least amount of tannins, so you can sit there and eat them all day, and you won't get sick from it. A lot of times, you're not supposed to eat a lot of star fruit because of tannins. So here we have some mangoes, and I'm not sure the variety, but I will say I have picked a few of these up, and Jared and Brittany have let me take are so delicious. This is kind of a rare one. It's called a pink banana. And I've never seen a pink banana until I started working at Sow Exotic. Above the pink bananas, we have some guavas. And I'm not sure of this guava variety. It could be the Thai white, or it could just be tree. I'm not sure, but this one here is, you can probably tell, it's a pomegranate tree. The pomegranates have kind of been through it. They've gotten a little bit of overhead water damage. That's kind of what the spots are from. And I've seen little success with the pomegranates this year. I think we've only had one or two actually, like, turn red. The other ones just seem to be sucking up a lot of water and turning white. See, like this one here? It busted open from the water. It got really juicy. It just needs popped off. It wasn't ready. This one is a favorite of mine. This is the doctor. This is Mother Moringa. And a lot of people don't know, but this isn't a tree. This is considered a weed of sorts. And how you can tell is by the bark. It will go straight up. Seed pods here. That way you can plant all the seeds. And this food really is a medicine. All of the leaves are edible, the bark, the seeds, the whole plant. People in India, they use this plant specifically for food and just health nutrition. So it's a cool one to have. This is a favorite one of mine, the muscadine grapes. And I believe these are the welders. They are a million times better than the store-bought grapes. They are so juicy and so, so sweet. You can tell they're ready by gently squeezing. And if it's not solid and it just kind of pops off, that's how you know that it's ready. These ones, they turn green. They're not like a purple grape, they're just a bright green. And I love snacking on these, probably more than like anything else in the whole food forest. They just have such a sweet, juicy flavor, and the texture is not like the store-bought grapes. It's very chewy. You can just kind of like slurp it out of the shell. It's very interesting. But I like to collect all of my seeds and, of course, plant them. That way you can keep the plant life going on forever and have abundance. This one here is also like a painting to me. It's a work of art. These big fruits are called ackee, and it's otherwise sometimes known as the cheese fruit. This is one that is so medicinal, and everybody should definitely collect it. These black seeds are not edible, This is a plant that I use daily in my skin routine, my hair routine. And I've noticed since using it that my skin is a million times softer, less breakouts, and my hair just feels completely renewed and brand new. So I seriously recommend checking out their shop, and hopefully soon I will have a link to give a discount code. So we're working on that right now. Here are some Japanese lanterns. This is at the front of their home, and for good reason. They're just so beautiful, and they always have pollinators. They just give such a beautiful vibe to their house. I love just looking at them each day. So this is another really cool favorite, the Seminole pumpkin. Check out how big this leaf is. It's twice the size of my head. And they're very like scratchy, kind of soft. And then of course it's beside it. Sitting around for all of us to read in our downtime. has like all of the necessities that you would need. It's got like the toilet area and then the shower area and the sink, and they have it all hooked up to their well water, so they can come outside, take a nice cool shower. And this is something that Brittany and Jared don't mind if we use often, so I love to take advantage of that. Their outside bathroom is for sure goals. Of course, they have the awabui and some ferns surrounding their outdoor shower area. That way they can just reach and grab some awabui whenever they want to get clean. It's got a really cool bench and just like an area to sit down. Their door, though, is probably the coolest part of the whole bathroom. Just the beautiful colors and the way that the sunlight hits it. It's so, so gorgeous. And I love tapping on the window. It's like an old stained glass. I'm not sure where they got this window door from, but it's these people.